Hey, that blue-eyed devil. The German that Francine took to her bed.
I told you before, adultery is none of my concern.
Ah, but this man concerns us all. He is head of military security in the industrial sector. Even now he hunts us, driven by his mad thirst for revenge.
Kill a man's woman, you take that risk.
She was my woman, not his.
Shut it! She was a Nazi spy, Mingo. Now get a hold of yourself.
This Nazi captain! They call him the Wolf. He hunts rebels for sport. It is only a matter of time before he finds this place and ties a rope around all our necks.
Then we'll find him first.
I already sent a team of my best men to hunt down this wolf. If you go now, you can catch up with them.
What's the score?
We have that Nazi bastard trapped. But those damn snipers won't let us get close enough to finish the job!
Mingo did not say anything about SS soldiers.
This must be the place. Let's move. Whatever you did to that crowd, it worked a little too well. Wanker never made it past the front desk.
I have not, as of yet, perfected the brainwashing technique. I will have...
Brainwashing? I'd rather my brain stay dirty. So what's the next step in this master plan of yours?
Unfortunately, my plans must be delayed. The Gestapo has dispatched a pair of notorious assassins to hunt me down. I had a crucial meeting scheduled for today, but... now I will not be able to meet my contact. The danger is too great. Unless, of course...
You want me to cover your back? Is that it?
There is a sniper's nest overlooking the square where the meeting is to take place. One of my colleagues will be watching the square from another building across the street with binoculars and a radio. If you position yourself in the sniper's nest, he will be able to help you spot any enemy agents in the crowd. I trust that you will kill them before they kill me.
You could find worse odds to gamble on, Doctor. I'll do what I can.
The heart you get, guys. Look at me. Oh, look at me. I'm somebody.
Top of the morning to you. Or whatever time it is.
Oh, great dinner. Anybody there?
Bonjour, Mr. Devlin.
All right. I'm in position. Keep your eyes peeled.
Kwong is entering the square now. I see nothing yet. Sniper, on the rooftop. The building on the left side of the square.
All right, keep your shirt on.
The building on the right side of the square. Quickly, he's taking aim. Target eliminated. That should do it. Wait, someone's coming. There, on the street. Three more agents closing in. We are sending the car back for Kwong. Keep him covered.
Now we're talking.
Doctor, what sort of mindfuck you got planned for the crowds this time?
The foundation of the fascist psyche is a nexus of fear and control. The tension between these opposing forces manifests itself as an obsession with power. Material, spiritual, and sexual power.
This isn't about your thing with women's underwear, is it?
For the last time, I do not wear women's clothing, Mr. Devlin.
I'm just saying. Maybe you should talk to a doctor about that.
The Nazis have installed a monstrous howitzer in the Pantheon Dome. The cannon's massive barrel thrusts into the sky above Paris like an engorged pillar of masculine flesh, while the women of the city tremble in the eclipsing shadow.
Suddenly I'm feeling a wee bit uncomfortable, Doctor. I'm afraid to ask where this is headed.
Don't you see? The cannon is a symbol of German authority in this area. We will drive a splinter of doubt into the heart of the Nazi forces. We will shatter their confidence and render them impotent.
I must confess, Doctor, that's...